2021 wrap up. You know, end of the year favorites are some of my very favorite style of videos to watch. So my good friend Claudia and I thought it would be really fun to do an end of the year favorites collaboration. I'm sure most of you are very familiar with Claudia. She has the channel Claudia Glows. Claudia is a physician assistant by training, but she likes to say that she traded in her stethoscope for her yoga mat. Claudia is stunningly gorgeous and she does not wear a stitch of makeup. Yet her channel is jam-packed full of extremely well-researched information, lots and lots of skincare, mind and body, holistic health and wellness. I always learn so much from Claudia. She is just a wealth of information. But more than that, Claudia has become a very dear friend. You know, Claudia was the very first YouTuber to welcome me here to YouTube just a couple of months after I started my channel. Claudia befriended me, took me under her wing, and invited me on my first collab. Since then, we have collabed multiple times. We talk on the phone on a regular basis, and I am super grateful to call Claudia my very dear friend. So after you watch this video, please make sure and go and visit Claudia. Give her my love. I know you will love her as much as I do. Today's video is sort of an overview of my 2021 favorites. I am hoping to do a couple more favorite videos in the next couple of weeks. But like I said, it's a little bit of an overview. So today I'm going to share with you three skincare favorites, three sort of cosmetic beauty type favorites, and three lifestyle favorites. And stay till the end of the video because I do have a little surprise for you. If that sounds fun to you, I would love it if you would throw this video a thumbs up, and we are going to jump into it right now. In preparation for this video, I took a look and reviewed my 2020 favorites. Last year, I did two end of the year favorite videos, one on skincare and one on cosmetics. And I wanted to review that and make sure I didn't have any repeats. In reviewing those videos, it made me really happy because every single one of the favorites that I talked about at the end of the year in 2020 has stood the test of time and remains a most used, most loved, holy grail favorite. So I will link those videos in the description box below because I still love and use every single one of those products. Okay, so we're gonna start with skincare. Skincare favorite number one, and I am going to be wearing my glasses for this video. Skincare favorite number one, medical microneedling for collagen induction. 2021 was the year where I finally tried medical microneedling. You know, it had been on my radar for quite some time. I know that medical microneedling can be done at the clinic, it can be done at home. The concept is it induces micro damage to the skin, which encourages our body to produce more collagen. And we know that as we grow older, our collagen production slows and slows and slows, which causes wrinkling and sagging and all that stuff. So like I said, medical microneedling had been on my radar for quite some time, but I was really intimidated. Once again, Claudia came to the rescue and she took me under her wing and we did a video where Claudia guided me through step by step my very first microneedling session. That video is listed and linked in the description box below and it is a wealth of information. So I'm not going to go into too much detail here. Medical microneedling is to use a needle depth of 0.5 millimeters or longer. And so I did purchase a derma roller, which is medical microneedling. And here it is. Again, I'm not going to go into a lot of detail, but I will say this. If microneedling is something that you are interested in, make sure you do your research. It's very, very important that you use the correct tool and the correct technique, because done incorrectly with the wrong tool, you can actually do more harm than good. So if this is something that is of interest to you, Claudia has lots and lots of great information on microneedling. And again, make sure you watch that video where Claudia walks me through step by step my very first microneedling session. Now, it is supposed to be done once a month. I haven't been super compliant. I think since July, I've only done it two additional times. I'm also looking into what's called cosmetic microneedling, which is where you use a needle depth of 0.3 millimeters or shorter. I think the upside of the cosmetic microneedling is it can be done more frequently There's less downtime and less, I think, potential for damage. So that is on my radar for 2022. Anyway, skincare, favorite number one, medical microneedling, and once again, thank you to my dear friend Claudia for walking me through step by step. Before we get into the next two skincare favorites, just a little caveat. You know, my skincare routine has not really changed super significantly in like 5 years. I do adjustments with the seasons. I post a spring summer skincare update and a fall winter skincare update, but I am pretty loyal to my products. I've used the same cleanser for many years. You know, if you've seen my skincare videos, you know you see the same products over and over. But this year I did make two pretty significant changes to my skincare routine, and these are favorites number two and number three. Skincare favorite number two, moisturizer. For at least 5 years, I was using and loving the CeraVe PM Moisturizing Lotion as my AM day cream. I loved it. Then last winter and spring, I started to notice my skin was feeling drier, a little bit more sensitive, and I just thought I was getting older and my skin was getting drier and more sensitive. But as it turns out, CeraVe did reformulate their PM Moisturizing Lotion, and when I found that out, it sort of explained why the CeraVe was occasionally stinging and irritating my skin and why it just didn't feel moisturizing enough anymore. So I went down a rabbit hole to find a replacement for my beloved CeraVe PM Moisturizing Lotion. I actually did a video on this, which I will link and list in the description box below. But in a nutshell, I now have three day creams that I use depending on the time of year and depending on how dry my skin is. During the summer months, when my skin is not quite as dry, it's sort of dry normal, I used and loved the Vanicream Daily Facial Moisturizing Lotion for sensitive skin. Oh my gosh, this is a fabulous moisturizer. It's lightweight, it soaks in, but it's very hydrating. It's very, very simple. It has hyaluronic acid, ceramides, nothing fancy. You can find it at any drugstore, super affordable. Highly recommend this. That is what I use in the summer when my skin is not quite so dry. Fall, winter, when my skin is more dry, I have been loving this Purito Centella Unscented Recovery Cream. This is my second tube. I absolutely love it. It is extremely hydrating. It is loaded with Centella Asiatica, which is a very potent anti-inflammatory and antioxidant. There is the texture. You can see it's very rich and creamy. It's rich and creamy, but it soaks in beautifully to the skin. It is just loaded with skin-loving ingredients and hydrators. I absolutely love it. It has niacinamide, it has ceramides, it has so many wonderful, wonderful things. Again, this is not a full review. I'm just sharing my favorites. I am absolutely loving this. Very affordable, easy to order, Yes Style, Amazon. I love it. In the deep of winter, when my skin is extremely, extremely dry, Dr. Jart's Ceramidin Cream saves the day. This is more expensive. This is around $48 for 1.69 ounce. But this cream is so rich and so moisturizing and so protective. And I will use this when I am doing outdoor winter activities and I just need an extra shield of protection. It is a very rich cream. My gosh, it's so soothing. If you have chapped skin or windburn skin, I absolutely love this. I did stock up during the Sephora sale because they had it at 50% off. This, even though it's very rich in emollient, it does soak into your skin. It does not feel greasy, and I can wear this under makeup. So I know I'm cheating a little bit by saying skincare favorite number two is my new moisturizer, and then talking about three moisturizers, but they all have a very, very specific, defined, and important role in my skincare routine. Skincare favorite number three is a new SPF. And again, this is a major change to my skincare routine because for the past 5 years, I have used and loved EltaMD UV Elements Tinted Mineral Sunscreen. I talked about it many times. I still love it. It's still a good sunscreen. I still highly recommend it. But for me, the tint is just a little too deep and a little too dark. But I could always make it work with, you know, foundation or whatever. I just really, really loved it. Anyway, last spring, I did a deep dive into sunscreens. Actually, it was a collab with Claudia where she tried 10 new sunscreens. I tried 10 new sunscreens. And I found quite a few sunscreens that I really, really loved. Well, two of those 10 sunscreens that I tried have risen to the top and have become my most used, most favorite sunscreens and have literally replaced the Elta MD in my routine. I actually tried the Elta MD the other day and it just is a little too deep and a little too dark for my skin. I can use it in the summer when I have a little bit more color, but the two sunscreens that have completely replaced the Elta MD in my daily routine, one is the Color Science Sun Forgettable Total Face Shield Sun Protection, SPF 50. This is 100% mineral. It has 12% zinc oxide. You have to shake it up. See how runny that is? It's just tinted enough to take the white cast away. And it disappears into my skin beautifully. It is very, very, very hydrating. It works beautifully under makeup. It soaks in. I absolutely love this. Now, if you have a deeper complexion, this might look a little bit light on you, but Color Science does have a variety of sunscreens with a variety of tints. Anyway, this is the Color Science Classic, the original version, and it works really well for me. It looks beautiful on my skin alone, and it works beautifully under makeup. This is $39 for 1.8 ounces. A little bit on the pricey side for sure, but you know, they do have frequent sales. This is my second one, and I already have a backup that I purchased during a recent sale. Then my other favorite sunscreen, so again, even though this is skincare favorite number three, new SPFs, I do have two of them. Like I said, the Color Science and also the Dermatology Universal Tinted Mineral Moisturizer SPF 44. I could not find it to hold up and show you. I'm gonna put a picture up here. I think I may have accidentally given it away thinking I had another backup. But the important thing is it is one of my top favorite mineral SPFs. The tint is beautiful. It soaks into the skin. It looks beautiful alone on the skin. It works great under makeup. It's very hydrating. I absolutely love it. And one of the reasons I love it so much is it is so affordable. It is $28 for 2.1 ounces. So it is quite a bit more affordable than the Color Science. And I do have a discount code for 20% off, which brings the price down even more. So it is a very, very affordable product. I have all the products I'm talking about today listed and linked in the description box below, but you will also find my Dermatology discount code in the description box below. So those are my three skincare favorites of 2021. All right, on to makeup, beauty, cosmetic type favorites. This one is actually one of my very favorite discoveries of 2021. It is the Tubing Mascara. This is the MAC Extended Play Giga Black Tubing Mascara. And I talked about this in several videos. You know, for years, I did not wear any mascara on my lower eyelashes because I would always get raccoon eyes. And I do not like waterproof mascara. It's just too hard to remove. And then I started hearing about tubing mascara. So I finally picked up this MAC during an Ulta sale. I think it was 21 Days of Beauty. It was on sale. It is the perfect mascara for my lower eyelashes. Look at that tiny, teeny little wand. This is not a thickening mascara. I really like a volumizing mascara on my upper lashes, but for the lower lashes, this is perfect. It just tints and coats these lower lashes and it never smudges. What a tubing mascara does is it sort of wraps around each lash, and I don't know what the technology is, but it doesn't smear, it doesn't smudge, it doesn't flake, and yet it rinses off extremely easily with warm water. This has been a game changer. Let me take my glasses off so you can, I don't know, can you see my lower lashes? I finally can wear a little bit of mascara on my lower lashes without worrying about raccoon eyes. I absolutely love this and I highly recommend it. Beauty cosmetic favorite number two. 2021 was definitely the year of cream cosmetics, cream blush, cream highlighter, cream eyeshadow. I did a full face of cream makeup not very long ago. I have another video where I talked about my top five favorite cream blushes. So I really got into cream makeup this year. It's really flattering on mature skin. It's hydrating. It's easy to use. So I'm just going to talk about one or two of my favorite cream products that I discovered this year. I have to talk about Milani Cheek Kiss Blush. I have it in the shade Nude Kiss, and I also have it in the shade Blushing Berry. Now I'm wearing Blushing Berry on my cheeks today. There is just something about this Milani Cheek Kiss formula that is just so lovely. It's just so silky and blendable. There is the Nude Kiss. I'm gonna swatch it there. It just blends in beautifully. I absolutely love it. It's so easy to use, and I'll swatch the Blushing Berry as well. There's the Blushing Berry. I don't know. You know, I've tried quite a few cream blushes this year, and the Milani Cheek Kiss just stands out as a number one favorite. I absolutely love it. Very affordable. One cream product that is not quite as affordable, but is one of my favorite cream product discoveries this year, is the Charlotte Tilbury Eyes to Mesmerize in the shade Oyster Pearl. First of all, the color is just a perfect, shimmery, neutral taupe. The consistency is a really moussey texture. So easy to apply, so easy to blend with your fingers, with a brush. Pricey, yes. Gorgeous, absolutely. I absolutely love it. This is one of my favorite cream eyeshadows, for sure. So beauty favorite number two, definitely cream cosmetics. Like I said, really beautiful on mature skin, easy to use, moisturizing, long lasting. And I just shared some of my favorites with you. And of course, once again, everything is listed and linked in the description box below. Okay. Beauty favorite number three. I'm gonna take my glasses off for this. You know, I have always really enjoyed makeup brushes, eyeshadow brushes, blush brushes, sponges. It's just really interesting to see how a different tool can make makeup application easier or harder. I have lots of very affordable brushes that I love from Real Techniques, e.l.f., Wet n Wild. You know, up until a couple of months ago, I had never tried any natural fiber brushes. And what these natural fibers are really good at doing is picking up and holding onto powder products and then distributing them really nice and evenly. And I had seen so many ladies here on YouTube talking about the Reffer brushes. Reffer has a huge line of brushes, Japanese made, made of goat hair. And I'd seen so many women love these brushes. So when Reffer offered to send me some brushes in PR, I was like, yes, please. So I have three favorites that I want to share with you. These are my three most used Reffer brushes. You can see there are two fluffy blending brushes of different sizes, and then a flat shader brush. I'm going to talk about the fluffy blending brushes really quickly first. This is the Reffer number 14. You can see it is much smaller than the Reffer number 27. This Reffer number 14 is so perfect for detailed application. You know, especially when you have small eyes or hooded eyes, if you use too big of a brush, your eyeshadow can get away from you really, really easily. By using this very small, detailed, but still fluffy, you can apply your makeup exactly where you want to in a very specific and detailed way. And it's soft enough to do a little bit of blending as well. And then the Reffer 02, again, a flat shader brush, has been perfect for picking up and holding onto shimmer shadow and just applying it very, very gently to the eyelid. But my favorite Reffer brush is the Reffer 27. And I try to keep this brush clean. It's a little bit too big for application of my eyeshadow, but it is the perfect size, shape, and texture to very, very, very gently buff the edges of my eyeshadow, blend the edges of my eyeshadow so my eyeshadow has a very soft, diffused look. I absolutely love this Ruffer number 27 for blending. But I am gonna say, the star of the show, my most favorite makeup brush of 2021 is the BK Beauty Angie Hot and Flashy Concealer Brush. It is the perfect size and shape to blend concealer. It's perfect. Like I said, it is perfect for just patting in your concealer, blending the edges. You can spot conceal with it. It's multi-purpose. It's soft. It's perfect. I absolutely love it. This is the 2021 brush of the year. Currently, this brush is only available as part of the Angie Hot and Flashy brush set, which is a great brush set. Several eyeshadow brushes, a blush brush. It's a lovely, lovely brush set. But I am hearing that at some point BK Beauty will be offering all the Angie Hot and Flashy brushes individually. And when this brush is offered individually, I will be purchasing a couple of backups. Okay, three lifestyle favorites of 2021. I have a movie, I have a game, and I have a safety product that I could not live without. First off, the movie. This movie was actually made in 2015, but I had never heard of it. It's called Harry and the Snowman. Oh my gosh. This is one of the most inspiring, uplifting, happy movies that I have seen in so many years. It's available on Amazon Prime. It is a true Cinderella story about a Dutch immigrant who came to the United States after World War II, and he rescued a plow horse from the glue factory. Within 2 years of rescuing Snowman, this huge white horse, they were winning every national championship for jumping. I mean, it is a true Cinderella story. They were a national treasure in the late 40s and the 50s, on the cover of Time magazine. I mean, it is just a beautiful, beautiful story. And if you haven't seen it and you want a feel-good movie, watch Harry and the Snowman. It is available on Amazon Prime. Lifestyle favorite number two, and this is sort of a safety item. Now, this is not a product I discovered in 2021, but it is a product I've never talked about on my channel before. And if you live in a warm climate where there is no snow and ice, this product is not going to apply to you. But if you live in a climate where there is snow and ice, and perhaps you like to walk outside, perhaps you like to walk your dog like I do, you know how treacherous it can be to walk on snow and ice. It is really dangerous. We can fall and break a bone, and nobody wants that. So for years, I would buy what's called yak tracks, and they're pretty reasonable. They're about $20. You can get them almost anywhere, but they only work so well, and they wear out really quickly, and I was going through like two or three different pairs of yak tracks every year. Well, I finally bit the bullet a couple of years ago and went to a sporting goods store and invested in a really good pair. I don't even know what we call these. I'm going to show you what it looks like on my boot. Here's my winter boot, and here's this little device. And you see these little, they're almost like little screws. I'm going to show you a close up here. These little screws dig into the snow and the ice, and you are not going to slip and fall no matter what. So when I am walking Bosley in the winter in the snow and ice, I always have these Catula nano spikes on my boots. In fact, I leave them on my walking boots so I don't even have to put them on and off my walking boots. I know that sounds like a silly, weird sort of favorite, but I could not live without these. I think they make a really great gift for somebody that lives in a cold climate that enjoys getting outside and walking if you have a dog to walk or whatever. I absolutely love these. So that is lifestyle favorite number two. Lifestyle favorite number three, and it is a game. And this is not a new game to me in 2021, but I have revisited it in a big way. You know, my Aunt Sarah, who lives next door, had a total knee replacement 3 or 4 weeks ago. And so we have spent hours and hours and hours playing Rummy Cube. My gosh, this is such a fun game, you guys. It's a great gift. It's an easy game. You can learn it in 2 seconds, but yet it does require some concentration. It's sort of like a combination of a puzzle and cards. I don't know. I'm sure many of you have played Rummy Cube, but if you have not, it is a super, super fun game. All right, so those are my favorites of 2021. If you have hung in with me this long, that makes me really happy because I hope that means that you enjoyed the video. And also, a huge thank you for hanging in there, because the longer people watch a video, the more YouTube will share it with other people who might enjoy it. So to thank you for hanging in there with me, I have a giveaway announcement, and it is the BK Beauty Travel Makeup Brush Set. I'm not going to take these out of the plastic, but there are two complexion brushes. One of them is the BK 101 foundation brush, which everybody loves, and then three eyeshadow brushes. So this is a beautiful, beautiful travel brush set. So if you would like to participate in the giveaway, here is all you need to do. In the comment section, just share with us any favorite from 2021. It can be a beauty favorite, a skincare favorite, a lifestyle favorite, a favorite, anything. Just use the word favorite somewhere in your comment and you will be entered in the giveaway for the BK Beauty Travel Makeup Brush Set. And this giveaway is open worldwide. So good luck on the giveaway. Like I said, I will announce the winner in my next video, and the winner will have a period of time to give me their contact information so that I can ship them their beautiful BK Beauty Travel Makeup Brush Set. Okay. I think that covers it. We did it. I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope you found it helpful. Please make sure you go and visit Claudia. I cannot wait to see what her favorites are. And please, I'm really looking forward to hearing what your favorites are in the comment box so you can be entered in the giveaway. With all that being said, please take really good care of yourself so that you can have a safe, happy, and healthy holiday. I look forward to visiting with you in the comments section, and I hope to see you in my video next Sunday. Happy holidays!